Hey everybody, The Real Deal here. I've got this Portal 2 level pack for LEGO Dimensions that I'm excited to open up here. It comes with Chell, the main character from the Portal games, a sentry turret, and the companion cube. And you can see you can build a few different versions of each one. There's a flying turret, there's different a gold heart emitter for the companion cube, which is really cute, sentry turret. So there's some cool stuff there. We're gonna build just the first two regular versions there. So let's open this up. I actually just played the regular Portal level in LEGO Dimensions and I thought it was awesome. Because, you know, if you play the main game, there is a Portal level that you can play through. And it's really fun. I think they did a good job mashing up Portal and LEGO. So I can't wait to play this actual Portal level. It should be pretty neat. So you can see it comes with instructions how to actually build Chell and her little portal gun there, but otherwise it doesn't tell you how to build the vehicles and gadgets and everything. You gotta either get the instructions online or watch a video like this one, or just put the character in the game and in the game will tell you how to build everything. So I've been pulling them up on my phone here so I can build them for you so we can take a look. So let's open everything up and check it out. So if you haven't actually played the original Portal games, Portal 1 and 2, you're really missing out. They are fantastic games. I know the original Portal is available, I believe, on the 360. I think it's also backwards compatible now, so you can play it on the Xbox One. There's the Orange Box collection that came out a few years ago with Half-Life 2 and Team Fortress, and then that has Portal in it as well, and Portal 2 is available, I know, on the PS3. And the Xbox 360. Yell yourself to check them out. They're just fantastic classic games. Look, we've got Angry Chell and we've got just kind of regular Chell. Let's give her the regular face there. So they're fantastic puzzle games, and the humor in them is fantastic. GLaDOS, who is the robot antagonist leading through all the test chambers, is just, it was an instant classic character. I can't say enough good things about Portal. You owe it to yourself to check them out. If you are a video game fan, you definitely need to check them out. So there's Chell. Let's get her Portal gun together here. There should be, looks like this, whoop, put it in the right way. It looks like this is just going to slide right in there. And there you go. We've got Chell's Portal gun, right? Yeah, it's that simple. And then we'll put that in her hand. And there we go, we've got Chell from the Portal games. How come that does not want to cooperate and go in her hand? Okay, well, you get the idea. That should slide into her hand. I guess a little bit easier, but okay. Well, we're not gonna spend all day on that, but you get the idea, that goes in her hand there. So there you go, there's Chell with her awesome looking LEGO Portal gun. So there you go. All right, so let's dive into building the sentry turret here. We're gonna build the companion cube first. That's what I have pulled up. So we're gonna build the companion cube, so let's do that. So first thing it says to do is put the base together, so that's pretty easy. You just snap this on there. There you go, and you've got your, they call it the toy tag, but that's really the base for the figure there. Okay, so then the next step is to take one of these white circular pieces and put that on top of there. So there we go. Okay, step three also looks pretty easy. We got two pieces like this. You're gonna put one on this side and then one on the other side, if I can find it. There we go. Whoops. So it's just gonna go just like that. Okay, great. Now, step four, looks like we take the cute little heart piece and put that on the other side. That might be hidden for now because we're not building the heart one, or like the heart emitter or whatever it's called. So, there you go. It's awesome that they got GLaDOS, the voice of GLaDOS, to come back and play the character in the game. Oh, whoop, I put the wrong one on there. We need to actually find, where is it? There should be one. Aha, looks like this. That's what it should look like, because you gotta put the heart here. And you know, not just the voice of GLaDOS, they got the voice of a lot of different characters from a lot of different franchises to come back and reprise their roles in the game. you know, Christopher Lloyd playing Doc Brown from Back to the Future, and people from Jurassic World and Scooby-Doo and the DC Comics, and it's just, it's amazing that they got all these people to come back. It's pretty cool. So, and it's a fun game. I absolutely recommend it. So, all right, anyway, so that was step four. Step five, it looks like above the little heart there, we're gonna take one of these pieces. Now we're gonna take the one that looks like this and put it on top there. All right. And then next to that, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna take one of these white pieces and put it over there. So that is step five, pretty easy. Step six is to take two gray pieces that look like this. And let me make sure, yep, they are facing the right way there. Okay, you've got one there. And then you're gonna take the other one and put it over here. So all told, pretty easy, right? And that's how that should look. Right now, as we move into step seven, which looks like an easy one, we're gonna take two of these blue pieces, put one here. Okay, and put another one over here. There you go. Okay, now step eight is to take two more blue pieces and put them the opposite way. So we're gonna connect, whoop, I don't wanna push the heart away. We're gonna connect one here. And we're gonna connect the other one here. All right, so we're building sort of a cube there. I think it's cute that they have the little Lego heart there. Okay, so that is step eight. Now step nine, oh, another easy one. We're just gonna go ahead and take this piece and put it on top. And there we go. All right, so step 10, okay, I see what they want us to do. You're gonna take, you got two pieces that look like this, right? And then you should hold them like this, and it's saying they should have red pieces that go inside here. So you should be able to take one of these red pieces and do that. Or nope, maybe that. There you go. And you should be able to take another red piece and do that there. Okay. Oh no, that doesn't make any sense, because you're supposed to then put something on top of that. So how does that go in there? No, that doesn't make any sense at all. So let's see. Oh, maybe it's this piece. Aha, that's what I'm doing wrong. Okay, everybody. Oh, now those are gonna be a pain in the neck to get out of there. One and two. Okay. Sorry, everybody. Okay, so look, you're gonna take this piece, okay? That makes a lot more sense. And now you're gonna put the red thing there and the red thing there, okay? And that is going to go on top of here. One's gonna go like this. And then you're gonna do the same thing on the opposite side. So now that we know the correct piece that we're using there, gotta take that and you're gonna take that. Okay, so there you go. Sorry about that, everybody. Okay, but there you go. So that is step 10 there. So now that's what that should look like with those red pieces in the middle there. Because for step 11, and the reason I was confused about the last one is because you gotta take this and put them on top, and that would not have worked if I had done it the way that I originally did it. So that piece goes on top there. Also for step 11, we're gonna take one of these pieces right here and stick that on top there. So there you go. So we're already on step 12. Now step 12 is where these pieces come into play. You're gonna take one and put it here. And you're gonna take one and put it on the other side, so you have yourself a cube, effectively. There you go. So that's what our current companion cube should look like, right? So looking pretty cool there. So now step 13 is to take all these little companion cube panels and put them on all five sides that we have exposed here. So it can start to look like the companion cube from the game. Oh, look at that, they all have little hearts on them. I put this one upside down. So let's make sure the hearts are facing the right way there. I don't know if the camera can pick that up. Yeah, you can kind of see that. So let's make sure all the hearts are facing up. And I guess it doesn't particularly matter which way the heart is facing here. So we'll just kind of put it that way. There you go. Doesn't really matter. Okay, so that's our companion cube. And then what it wants me to do on either side here, we're almost done, everybody, is to take these blue pieces and put one here and put another one here. So the companion cube is on its own weird little base there. So there you go. And then it says, yeah, step 15 is just to push these down like I did. And that's it. You've got your companion cube. So this is pretty neat. I wonder what this does in the game. I don't really know. I like it's got the little heart hanging on there. So it'll be interesting to see how to use this in the actual game. But I guess I'll find out once I plop it in there. So it looks pretty neat. So that's a nice little companion to Chell here and her portal gun. And then we're going to build the wonderful sentry turrets. They sound benevolent when they talk to you in the game, but they are actually quite deadly. So for the first step, we're going to take this white piece here, and then we're going to take one of these black pieces, and that's going to go on the back here. Well, it might be the front. I don't really know at this point, but I guess we'll find out. And then we're going to take these two pieces that look like this, and we're going to face them this way. One's going to go here, and one's going to go over here. And then also for step two, we're going to take this white piece and put that there. Okay? Now, for step three, what we're going to do is take this black piece and put it on top. That's going to kind of hold all that together there, nice and snug. All right. Now, step four is to take this piece, well, it looks like a little bar, and just kind of snap that in there. Okay, kind of center it so it looks right. And then also you've got four of these little gray pieces. That's what it looks like to me. One, two, three, four, yeah. Okay, well, those are gonna go on the sides here. Okay, like that. One, two, three, and four. Okay, so that was step four. Now step five, it looks like we're gonna kinda put the front of the turret on here. So this is gonna go like that, okay? And then we're also gonna put this white piece with only the one little button there on top like that, okay? So with me so far, great. Now step six, we're gonna put the little eye on the turret, it looks like. We're gonna take one of these gray pieces here and put it there. And then on top of that, we're gonna put the little red eye, which I dropped. There you go, cool. All right, so now step seven, on either side of the turret, we've got these pieces here. So it looks like you're gonna snap one here, okay? And you're gonna snap one over here. So there you go, those are the sides of the turret starting to come together, looking pretty cool. Then it looks like for step eight, we're gonna put the little legs on the turret. So the way we're gonna do that is you take these pieces, okay? And it looks like you're gonna hold them like this, and you're gonna take one of these little claw-like things and stick it in there, or drop it like I did, but you should be able to stick it in there just like that, so it looks like that. And you're gonna do that twice. Okay, so we'll do that again right here, ta-da. Okay, and then those, as part of step eight, are gonna snap on to this little bar that you put down here, and that's why I said keep it centered, so you could have one leg on either side. So can I? There you go, there's one. It's cool that it moves. And then there's the other leg for the sentry turret. So there you go. Starting to look pretty neat there. Now step nine says we have to build something separate. So we're gonna put this down for a minute, okay? And we're gonna pick up this piece, okay? And then on either side of that, we're gonna take these little clip-on pieces here with the little claw and put those on. And those are facing the right way. Or these little claw pieces are facing the right way. And then on the back of that, oh, I see, that's pretty neat. You're gonna take these yellow pieces here and put one there like that. And then put the other one there like that. And they snap in pretty easily. And now this is where you're gonna put this on the actual turret itself. And it looks like we're gonna hold it this way. And I did it right. It looks like they just want me to snap that in like this. So you don't even really see those yellow lights. But that's gonna get snapped in just like that on the back, on the bottom of the piece, that this big long white piece here. Okay, now step 10, oh, there's another one where it says put this down, so we're gonna put that down. And it says to take this piece, okay, and underneath that piece, we're gonna take these like cylinder-like pieces and put kind of one on either side, so one there and one there, okay? So that's what that should look like. Now, step 11 is to go ahead and take this white piece and put it like that, okay? And then now, oh, it looks like we're gonna build, put some lasers behind it here. So step 12 is to take, okay, I see what they want me to do. You're gonna put this down for a second and you're gonna put these two black claw looking things. You're gonna take them and you're gonna put these red laser pieces in them. All right, so take two of those. All right, that's simple enough, right? Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna hold this like this and these clip on here and then you push them down, okay? Simple enough. So there you go. And then now that is going to snap onto the back of the main turret. And it's just, I guess, hiding these lasers in the back, because I guess when you build the other versions of this, you use those laser pieces. But for now, they're just gonna kind of be hidden kind of cleverly on the back of the turret there. So there you go. So that was step 13, step 13, snapping that on the back there. Now, step 14, we're gonna put the other legs on the turret. We're gonna keep the turret upside down for now, so we're gonna kind of keep this like this. Okay, and then before we attach those on, we actually have to build those little legs. So you wanna take one of these, okay? And then underneath that, you're gonna take one of these black pieces. And then in there, you're gonna take another one of these little leg pieces, okay? And it's gonna get attached facing this way with the curve like that, okay? Then we're gonna do another one just like that. Where's my little white piece? How am I missing that piece? I don't see it. I don't see my little white piece that I need. Where are you? Okay, all right, bear with me, I'll find it. Well, you know, I've never had this happen, but I seem to be missing a piece. I seem to be missing another one of these white claw pieces here, so that's okay. We're gonna kind of keep going just in case, or we're gonna keep going anyway is what I mean. So, you know what? I am a dummy. You only need one of them. That's why I can't find another one. I thought there were two, there's only one. Ay, ay, ay. I am sorry about that. I stopped the video and everything. I just spent forever looking for it, and I finally looked back at the instructions, and there's only one. So, sorry. Well, so this one snaps on here. I was gonna say, it's not like these to be missing pieces. They're usually very good with that. So, that snaps on the back there like that. Don't drive yourself crazy looking for a second one, because there's not one. Learn my lesson, or learn the lesson from me. So, all right. So moving on, let's go ahead and build the last step here. We're gonna take this piece here okay, which there's only one of, and then we're going to take one of these little antenna pieces, okay, and they want me to face it kind of this way, all right, like that, and then you're going to take one of these and put it on top like that. Oh, should snap right in there. Why does that not want to snap in? There it is. Okay. That snaps like that. And then from there, we're going to take this piece and snap it on the top like that. So it looks like that. And then this is going to snap onto the top of our sentry turret. And we'll complete the sentry turret, not without a little bit of drama there, as I went crazy looking for pieces that didn't exist, but it's got three legs. You can see the back leg there. So again, sorry I went crazy about like that, but now you don't have to. So there you go. There's the awesome looking sentry turret. Let's get it on its base. I imagine you can ride around on this in the game. That's usually the case with these, so that'll be pretty fun to be blasting stuff away as the sentry turret. So on top of the base, you're going to put this white piece here. And then on top of that, you're going to put this little clip here. And it looks like we're going to go ahead and just kind of clip the sentry turret to the base there. Let's move his legs so he's able to do that, so you can see what he looks like on there. So there you go. Oh, I think I clipped the back part, and I should have clipped this part. There we go. Oh, last little bit of drama for the sentry turret. So there he goes. Looks really neat now that it's actually all together there. Oh, look, and I snapped this claw off. Man, I'm having some bad luck with this sentry turret. So I hope your build goes a lot easier than mine did. I think this is cool. Like I said, Portal is an awesome franchise. It's super cool that it's part of LEGO Dimensions. If you're a Portal fan and you're a LEGO Dimensions fan, pick this up. Why not? It's awesome. And I hope you watch my other LEGO Dimensions videos. I've built a lot of other ones. They went a lot smoother than this one. So you should check out the playlist on my channel. I've got tons of other unboxing videos as well. Links to all my other stuff in the description of this video. So thank you so much for watching. Hope you like, subscribe, and share. Thanks again. Keep on collecting.